our coronavirus detectives, our public health team. That takes us to 1,417 active cases, with 1,414 of those locally acquired. I'll give you an age breakdown, which I know is always of interest, and just confirms that this really is a pandemic now of the unvaccinated. 216 of our cases are aged 0 to 9, 232 are aged 10 to 19, 348 are aged in their 20s, and 245 are aged in their 30s. Of the new cases today, 91% are under 50. There are 89 people in hospital, and we send our best wishes to each and every one of them and their families, and of course to the teams of dedicated professionals who are caring for them. There are 24 people that are in ICU and 13 are on a ventilator. Only one person that's in hospital has been fully vaccinated. Again, just making the point that if you are double dose protected with either of the vaccines that are available, then you are almost certain to avoid very serious illness. That's yet again another reminder and another really important point to make about the need to get vaccinated and to get vaccinated quickly. Turning to vaccinations, some 29,950 vaccines were administered yesterday. That's our in state clinics. That's our busiest weekend day since the vaccination rollout began, our biggest ever. We are now at 2,583,499 doses having been administered through state-run centres. We across the board, we've hit our 60% first dose administered target, and we are well on our way to achieving the 1 million jabs over a five-week period. We are indeed ahead of that a bit, and we should meet that target ahead of schedule. That's fantastic. We've just got some 343,000 to go, and I'm confident we'll get there and get there ahead of the five-week mark. Just to give you an example of just how much activity there is in our vaccination system, some 39,000 bookings were made yesterday. That means, Friday I was talking about 50,000 AstraZeneca appointments. I can now pleasingly report to you that there are just 11,000 AstraZeneca first dose appointments available over the next 7 days, and some 2,000 first dose Pfizer appointments available over the next 7 days. Those numbers are steadily getting lower. Doesn't mean that it's any less worthwhile getting online right now as you watch or listen to this press conference. Put your name beside one of those AstraZeneca appointments, 11,000. I'd like to think that when we're standing up here in the coming days, there are no more appointments available this week. Then we'll order more, and hopefully we'll be able to run a whole lot of new appointments in the weeks to follow. But there are 11,000 first dose appointments available right now. Please go online. When you get to honouring your appointment, when you turn up at the state hub, there'll be a doctor, a pharmacist or a senior nurse to speak with you about what AstraZeneca means, and then you can make hopefully an informed choice. You can get that vaccine, you can be back 6 weeks later to get your second dose, and you can be fully protected, both you and the people that you love the most. You won't be helping in the spread of this virus. You will have in fact helped all of us to get to the other side of this and to get to that 80% double dose mark, the mark that allows us to have our freedom back and to live in a very different set of rules, a very different set of circumstances. 11,000 of those AstraZeneca appointments are available over the next week. They're available right now. Please go online and snap those up. I would also just remind people that schools will have been and will continue over the course of this weekend to be communicating with their Year 12 students and Year 11 students who are doing Year 12 exams. Bookings start tomorrow, and the Year 12 or Senior Student Vaccination Blitz at VCE Vaccination Blitz begins on Tuesday and runs through until Friday the 17th. That's first dose. I'll just say anyone who's got an appointment with a GP, anyone who is already in a different system, if you like, please continue with those plans. Please honour those plans. We've got capacity to get everybody done, but I think we'll get the task done quicker if everybody works as a team. And obviously state hubs are a big part of this, a very big part of it. It'll be the overwhelming majority, but there are some people who've got arrangements with their own family GP, and if we can all work together, then we'll get these numbers done. It's not a small thing, but that priority access, priority treatment is absolutely imperative as we get closer and closer to Year 12 exams beginning. And if we can have all of those Year 12s through that process, at least with one dose, some will be double dosed because they will have access vaccines prior to this program. But that's very important protection for them. It's not ultimate protection, but it is very, very good protection against transmission and against serious illness. It's a really important part of our vaccine rollout in coming days. Just on testing, it's been a lot spoken, a lot written in recent times about, you know, test numbers and how important it is that we have as complete a picture as possible. The speed with which you get results back to people really is the most important point. You want a good number, you want a good strong number, and we've seen that each day, every day in recent weeks. But it's all about how recent, how accurate is that picture. If you've got tests coming back that are 3 days old, then they're not a great, they're not a lot of use to our contact tracers. That's why it's so pleasing that in the order of 98-99% of our test results come back the following day. That's the most complete and most recent picture, and it makes the task just that little bit more meaningful, a little bit easier. Nowhere near easy, but a little bit easier than trying to work off data that's days and days old. That's just a long way of saying thank you to our laboratory teams. They're doing an amazing job processing in the order of 50,000 tests a day and doing it really fast. Together with all the people out there in testing clinics taking swabs, it is not only a comprehensive picture of what's going on, but it's timely. It's relevant to what's actually occurring out there because they're being processed fast. That's the metric that we'll continue to be focused on. To that end, though, there were 48,847 results received overnight. So that's a good, strong number for a weekend day. The 98.6% of those have been provided the day after the results, the day after the swabs were taken. That's a very, very important metric. In terms of testing sites, there are new sites that were opened yesterday in Brunswick, Coburg and Craigieburn. The Coburg walk-in saw about 200 swabs taken yesterday. There's another new site today in Keilor at the basketball stadium. That'll open on Monday, apparently, so it'll open tomorrow. Shepparton and Demand, I just want to give a shout-out to the people of the Golden Valley. Many thousands of people isolating at home, many thousands of people caught up in the outbreak, and many, many hundreds of people, volunteers and other staff, doing an amazing job supporting those families and supporting a whole lot of essential services and functions throughout the Goulburn Valley. Can I just give a shout out, obviously Deb Abbott and her team at EMV, but can I give Susanna Sheed, the local member up in Shepparton, a shout out? I've spoken to her numerous occasions. She's been on the phone to so many of my colleagues, pushing us, making sure that we understood exactly what was going on in Shepparton. Very resilient community, but sometimes things just become a bit overwhelming, and it's very important that there's appropriate support, and that's what we've done. She's a great champion for her local community, and we're indebted to her for that constant feedback and her hard work. Her electorate office has essentially become a relief centre, and her and her staff should be very proud, and we're very grateful for the partnership we have with her, delivering for her local community. In Shepparton, demand is starting to wind down. Those day 13 tests are unfolding. There's some 36,734 tests that have been conducted in Shepparton since the outbreak began. So that just gives you on one metric a sense of just how big a task and just how much work has been done in the Goulburn Valley. We're very grateful to those communities. They're proud and strong, they stick together, they look out for each other, and they're much better for that. We're there to help as well, and that's why there's been such a significant presence. I just want to remind everybody, just before I throw to Minister Dunellan to speak about some other important matters, I just want to remind everybody that if you would be without pay, if you would be missing out on a shift because you went and got tested and you had to isolate until you got your results the following day, there is a $450 payment available to you. So if you're a casual worker, if you don't have annual leave and sick leave to fall back on, in order to do the right thing by the rest of us and go and act on your symptoms, go and be immediate with a sense of urgency to act on your symptoms and get tested, if you'd be out of pocket, then there is a $450 payment. It's essentially no questions asked. We make it quickly. We've made thousands of these payments because we know that many people who are in less secure work circumstances and that, you know, the absolutely toxic nature of insecure work, this has become well known to us, well known to all of us. So that's why that $450 payment is there. In the event that you test positive, then there's a further $1,500 payment available to you. So we will stand with you, we will look after you, and you should come forward and get tested for your family and for every single family. And as I said, we have made thousands of these payments because we know that this virus has ripped through so many different communities and so many people in insecure circumstances, employment circumstances, and uncertain financial circumstances, where there's not thousands and thousands of dollars in the bank for them to fall back on. We want them to do the right thing and never have to choose between feeding their family and protecting every family. That's why those payments are there. I just remind you, those payments and the details, it's all on the website. If you need that funding, it is there. That's what it's designed for. Those payments are there to be made, not to be sat on. Now, yesterday, the Minister for Business Support, Mr. Pakula, made a whole range of announcements in partnership with the Commonwealth, a very substantial business support package. And it seems to me that there's been very strong feedback, positive feedback from those who are constructive about these things. You know, we can't provide everything. We can't replace everything that is lost through these sorts of measures, but it is a very substantial package of support. We're grateful to the Commonwealth for their partnership. And there's been, both to me personally and I think in the media, quite supportive commentary about the nature of this package. The companion piece of work, if you like, is a comprehensive package to extend the different measures and programs we have in place for the most vulnerable, those in our community who don't necessarily have a vecchi or someone like that to stand up for them, people who really do it very, very tough, and people for whom the burden of this virus can be particularly acute. On that basis, we've extended and made further decisions to extend all sorts of support to those in our community who often have the least power, those who are the most vulnerable, and those for whom this support is so, so meaningful.